Hello, YouTubers. I'm in Hatton, and there's the river to the rear of me, and I'm just about to magnet fish a big pool, which looks as though it's like an off cut of where the River Trent goes, and I'll switch cameras so I can show you the location. Just bear with me.
It's the bridge that leads towards the Nestle factory. Some cars going over there. And this is the pool area. It's quite shallow, that's the part of it. And it's in a bit of a dip. So just one of these two trees. And if you went straight, it would take you to the main link of the arc of the Trent. So I'm going to set the camera up so I can do some magnet fishing. So here we go.
Right, here we go. My gloves are still a bit muddy from last time I went magnet fishing. So the magnet, I think I need to stick it in the bath and give it a little hosing down. So here we go, let's see what we can get. Secured my magnet to the tree. My first throw. This same pool looks a bit stagnant, so yeah, I definitely need to wash my magnet after going in here. Nothing that time. There's an old saying, isn't there, where there's muck, there's grass. And look at that, look at the muck there. I think there's about a couple of thousand years of mud in there. Not good. It's nice that the weather's getting a bit warmer. I think I'm a bit hot in this sheepskin jacket. On the bridge next to the car park, just off the island, there's a little, like a kid's push bike, and it's wedged up against the wall, but it's like it's been there that long that the plants have grown all around it, so I'm not sure whether I can get that out. I'm not even sure what I'd do if I did get it out. Oh, a bumblebee, fantastic. I love bumblebees. I'm thinking I might need to get a longer rope because 10 metres, I don't think it's really enough. I've got hold of something there. wallpaper. It's not just rusty nails like my other magnet fishing sessions I do. Anything? No! Not even magnetic ropes! I've just dropped my sister off in Tutbury. We've just been for lunch somewhere. And so I say, yeah, would you like to go magnet fishing? She said, no, it's not really my thing. I've always been, you know, the random one of the family anyway. So like, oh, what's she doing now? Nothing. I'd like to say hello to all my most recent subscribers. Welcome to my channel. I like to keep people entertained. Oh my God, what have I got stuck on? Come on. I can feel something now. That lucky dip, isn't it? Lucky dip in water. I think I might have to invest in one of those double-sided magnets one day. They look really good. Definitely something down there. I get this feeling of great disappointment when I pull it out and there's nothing on it. You never know what you're going to get out of the water, do you? You never know. Nothing, just mud. Right, I'm not finding a great deal here, so I'm going to pause and go and see if I can fish the river over that side. Catch you soon. Right, I've moved over towards the river. I'm going to try and fish between the edge and that piece of brickwork. So I'll see if I can get it in that gap. Bearing in mind, I've only got 10 metres, so. They say size matters, I think it might here. just rusty metal. That made a nice splash. More little fragments of rusty metal. See, I took it right to the end of the limit of the rope then. Ooh. Nice chunk of magnetic rock or remnants of metal. Who knows? There's some stories going around about some lost treasure around this, by the way, this area. It was one of the kings that had lost a massive bag of coins. I don't think I'll get a bag of coins, I'll probably just get a couple of 2p's. Guess what I did? I stood on the roof. Yeah, I found something. L-shaped piece of metal. Not quite sure what it is. First find. I must learn to stop treading on my blinking rope. More little shards of metal, magnetic rocks, yay! It's quite entertaining, isn't it, playing with these?